Hi, I'm Paul Peterson. Today, I want to share how religion changed the way I understand and accept others. This may sound like a story you've heard before, but my story is a little different. I was raised in the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. Members of my faith are sometimes referred to as Mormons. Growing up, I remember having friends of other faiths, but there were always times when I felt a little different. I didn't understand why I couldn't play in our soccer games on Sundays, or why other people could drink coffee, but my family couldn't. It was hard not to feel like an outsider, and even harder to understand why there weren't more families like ours. So when we moved to Utah with a larger population of church members, things started to come together. The outsider feeling I had growing up began to subside, and I grew accustomed to being surrounded by people who thought like me and believed what I believed. Because of that, I didn't always know how to interact with those outside my faith. Then in high school, I started having feelings I didn't quite understand and began wondering about my sexual orientation. I was afraid to talk about it with anyone because I didn't want to be judged by others or feel like an outsider again. During my time as a missionary for the church, I went to Japan to teach not just about my religion, but also Christianity. I knew that many in Japan were Buddhist or didn't have a religious preference, so I was eager to teach and serve. But to my surprise, I ended up becoming the student. I began to understand that there are great people all across the world who have different faiths or who don't believe in religion at all. It was a turning point in my life that made me curious to learn more about the idea of dialogue between people of different faiths. I joined the National Guard at the age of 19 as a combat engineer, but quickly decided to change roles. As a religious affairs specialist, my role was to find ways to help my fellow soldiers exercise their religion freely. But it was also a way to find myself, and I did. As I traveled the world, the beauty of other cultures came to life. I walked the cathedrals of Germany. I saw some of the world's most beautiful mosques. I visited amazing shrines and Buddhist temples across Japan. I began to realize that we are all more alike than we are different. This made me enthusiastic and eager about my new role. But shortly after I began my work, I witnessed some heated conversations between members of separate faiths that concerned me. In fact, I can recall a conversation where a fellow trainee told me that I would burn in the fiery pit of hell if I didn't repent for believing in what he saw as a false religion. When I told my supervisors about the comment, I simply wanted to convey that I believed our job was to remain understanding and empathetic of others, no matter what their beliefs were. But somehow my words reached chaplain high command, and I was inspired by the feedback I received from one of my instructors, Sergeant First Class Vanessa Davis Williams. She said, "Peterson, you have a voice, and it deserves to be heard." For the first time in a long time, someone was telling me to speak up for what I believe in. Her words changed me forever. And that is why I'm here today. Before any of us ever believe, we belong. No matter what our faith, whatever our culture, we are all people, and we all belong. And in a world so divided, now is the time for us to come together with love and respect. Today, I am a happily married father of two. I am a man of deep faith, and I identify as bisexual. Through my studies and travels, I've seen the beauty of different faiths and cultures, and I've learned that there is room for all of us at the table. I'm asking you to make room for everyone at your table. Judge others by their character, not by their religion, or what you assume they believe, or by their culture and traditions, or their sexual orientation. Different spiritual beliefs do not mean that we have nothing in common. I try to look past our differences and find the common ground. We all play a part in creating a world where we reach forward with trust and love and not bias and fear. Thank you.